Hello, this is your daily dose of news from On Manorama. I'm your host, Deepa Soman, and these are the major news stories of the day. Prime Minister Modi inaugurated Kerala's Vande Bharat Express, Kochi Water Metro, and a host of other major projects today in Thiruvananthapuram. First batch of Indians left Sudan under Operation Kaveri. US President Joe Biden made his 2024 presidential run official. Kerala government likely to include in its textbooks the history lessons omitted by the central government. Over 400 parents of LGBTQIA plus persons write to CJI seeking right to marriage equality. Let's get into the details. Prime Minister Narendra Modi flagged off the Vande Bharat Express in the state in Thiruvananthapuram today. He flagged off the train from the Thiruvananthapuram Central Railway Station at 11:10 a.m. The Prime Minister, who landed at Thiruvananthapuram Airport around 10:10 a.m., greeted supporters from his car while en route to the railway station. Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan and Kerala Governor Arif Muhammad Khan received him at the airport. He also officially launched various railway development projects worth ₹2,033 crore at the meeting held at the Central Stadium. The PM also unveiled district-level projects including Kochi Water Metro and laid the foundation for the country's first digital science park in the state capital. The first group of Indians stranded in Sudan has left the conflict-hit nation in an Indian Navy warship for Saudi Arabia's Jeddah, the Foreign Ministry said today. Foreign Ministry spokesperson Arindam Bagchi tweeted photos of the Indians on board the INS Sumedha. India had positioned two transport aircrafts in Jeddah and the INS Sumedha at Port Sudan as part of the operation. The security situation in Sudan continues to be volatile, with reports of fierce fighting coming from several locations in the country's capital, Khartoum. US President Joe Biden said on Tuesday he will seek a second White House term in 2024. The 80-year-old is the oldest US president ever. The announcement was made in a video released by his campaign team. Biden described Republican platforms as threats to American freedom. He also swore to fight efforts to limit women's health care, cut social security and ban books. The president also spoke against the Make America Great Again extremists. Biden will be joined in his 2024 quest by his running mate, Vice President Kamala Harris. The Kerala government is likely to include in its textbooks the history lessons omitted by the central government. The State Council of Education Research and Training will prepare special textbooks to teach topics omitted from syllabus by National Council of Educational Research and Training. The decision was taken in the State Curriculum Committee meeting on Tuesday. The final decision will be taken by the Education Minister. The Curriculum Committee has criticized the NCERT for omitting portions on freedom fighters, Gujarat riots and RSS ban from the textbooks. In a move that should instill confidence in the LGBTQIA plus community's fight for equality, SWECAR, the Rainbow Parents, a group of over 400 members with LGBTQIA plus wards, has written to Chief Justice of India D.Y. Chandrachud, urging that their children be granted the right to marriage equality. The letter assumes significance as it comes when a 5-judge constitution bench headed by the CJI is hearing a batch of petitions seeking legal validation for same-sex marriage for the fourth day. We desire to see our children and children-in-law find final legal acceptance for their relationship under the Special Marriage Act in our country. We are certain that a nation as big as ours, which respects its diversity and stands for the value of exclusion, will open its legal gate of marriage equality to our children too. We are growing old. Some of us will touch 80 soon. We hope we will get to see the legal stamp on the rainbow marriage of our children in our lifetime, the group said in its letter. That brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening to Daily News Dose, hosted by me, Deepa Soman. Daily News Dose podcast is produced by Vishnu Muralidharan with technical production by Idea Brew Studios. Follow on manorama.com for detailed updates on the latest news and be sure to come back tomorrow.